as the one Landrew provided.
Yes. And we never got it. Just lucky, I guess.
Friday, Dead Men Do Tell Tales, when Arena unearths the connection between an eerie American rock band with its roots in the 60s and the mysterious foundation behind the revival of neglected masterpieces from Britain's musical heritage.
If you have to call the Grateful Dead for assistance, you're definitely falling between the cracks of all major charities.
From flower power to the flowering of Britain's unsung musical talents. Arena, Friday, 9:30 on BBC2.
Hello, so you want to be a rock and roll star?
All lies. Not a word of truth.
I've a good mind to walk out.
Impromptu, isn't it?
Sounds of the 70s, Saturday, 7:15 on BBC2.
This week on Reportage, in our investigation of love, we seek out the new romantics.
Then they suddenly started being sloppy and whatnot, they were, they got used to it after a while.
And meet those who profit from passion.
We are peddling dreams in the music industry, but we're here to perpetrate myths.
And ask if you've got that loving feeling.
I generally feel like a 15-year-old when I'm in love.
Yes, I'm in love at the moment.
Welcome to Blackpool, Britain's Riviera of romance, where for decades love has blossomed among kiss-me-quick hats, exotic night spots and secluded B&Bs. And even in a week of royal separations which has shown that love can often turn sour or lead to shattered dreams, young people, it seems, still come back looking for more. This week, as we examine the passion closest to all our hearts, our search for the Big L's elusive secrets take us behind the love industry and to Japan, where love is for rent. First, though, we meet some young people on the prowl for passion.
I don't actually go out looking for people in case of disappointment.
I suppose the best place really is to go to the nightclub, you know, bars.
A Zambian cheese and wine party.
In Finland, in a sauna.
A bouncy castle.
Mainly in a church environment.
On an aeroplane.
Step one.
The most important decision in life is choosing who to spend it with and getting it right. But for most of us, what should be three steps to heaven can often be a test of endurance. Even the first stage, finding a partner, can be daunting.
One in three couples meet for the first time in pubs and clubs. So for Lucy, Levine, Iffy, Dawn and Dee, Friday night is party night. Hours are spent on preparation for the main event.
It's because people go out with this intention, because it's sort of like all like the preconceived ideas, people are expecting it, they're forcing it, they try too hard and you know,
it's
it never
too
happens.
Superficial. And when you've got That's when right. you're under pressure from your mates to have a good time and muck about, you the last thing you're gonna do is seriously try to get to know somebody.
Do you want to meet someone tonight, Lucy?
No.
You don't?
No.
Why are you spending all that time putting your makeup on?
Huh?
Is it for self-satisfaction?
No, I just want a bit of fun.
Hmm? Does that mean you're looking to pull?
Oh, absolutely. You watch me.
Looking to pull, eh, lass?
No matter how far you're prepared to travel to meet your perfect partner, the likelihood is that you'll find them close to home. For our girls, the evening really starts here, the local drinking haunt.
There's one that calls you like this.
Psst, psst. Oh, and that is
a chatterbox in itself, and that's not very nice. What am I, a dog? You run along, little boy.
Whatever your expectations of a Friday night on the town, if you do strike it lucky, the chances are you'll meet someone from the same race, class and religion. And with no likely liaisons there, it's on to one of the busiest nightclubs to check out the talent.